Tonight on our Christmas show, we've got imaginative practice for filing systems in community centres, a scheme from Wembley where they're recycling egg boxes, and an interview with a representative from St Albans Development Research Project Group. Right, that's got rid of all the suckers. Actually, really, we've got jugglers, films, cartoonists, and unfortunately, a band called Ivor Biggun and the D-Cups. But we start with the Islington Bus Company from North London, who, amongst other things, teach people how to print T-shirts and posters. Andy and Jeni are going to be in the studio, and they're going to be teaching us how to screen print throughout the programme. So let's start. How do you do it?
Well, basic equipment to start with. A good, solid wooden frame. It's a nice size to get this. You can buy these from specialist suppliers, or you can have them handmade. Make them yourself, OK? Next, some mesh. The best quality is industrially manufactured, but it has to be mechanically stretched. So for our purposes, we're using terralene organdy, because you can buy it in most shops. You can stretch it by hand, and it's cheap. Okay, and one of these is very useful, a staple gun. They're quite expensive, but if you don't want to buy one, then most schools have them, you can borrow them, okay? So to stretch the fabric over the frame, you want to cut yourself a piece 3 or 4 inches larger than the frame. Start at the top, well, one end, okay? And then stretch it as tight as you can from these two ends, right? You'll get creases in it, but as you work from this end, yeah, put staples in, all the creases start to come out. And it's a good idea to wet the fabric before you put it onto the frame, because when it dries, that shrinks as well, and that helps to get the right tension on the frame. So the finished one
looks like that.
This one's been used, as you can see, but it's got a nice tension on it, which is what you want.
Well, I'll leave you to get on finishing that one, and I'm going to go and introduce Ivor Biggun. Thank you very much. See you later. Now, Ivor.
Oh, hello, Jeni. It's nice to see you with your clothes on.
Yes. I'll That's better. Yes, Ivor. Why, tell me, are you on a self-help programme?
Well, I've always been interested in self-motivation and self-expression and self-improvement, as you probably can tell from my songs. And so I thought, why not come and give the viewers of Grapevine a little bit of what only I can provide?
Yes, I see. But, I mean, quite seriously, you actually do make your own records, don't you?
I do indeed, yes. I'm living proof that it's possible to make a top 20 record in one's living room.
What was yours called, or aren't you allowed to say
it? No, I'm not allowed to say it. It was so rude that even the BBC, they wouldn't even say the name. And it did honestly make the top 20, honestly.
Yes. Look, thank you, Ivor. We've got an information sheet on how to make your own records, so do write in, and Ivor and I will be crooning together our very own self-help song at the end of the show. But now, the singularly indefatigable Mr. To Ivor Biggun and the D-Cups. Take it away.
Thank you very much. I don't know what indefatigable means. Righto, lads, let's be indefatigable in the key of G. Here we go. Some people sing sad songs about mother and home. Some sing about wicked women. I leave them alone. Some sing about blue suede shoes and the romance that went wrong. But I pick up my ukulele and sing a mucky song. My ukulele, well, it won't bring me wealth if I play it with the band or play by myself. It's a very nice size and I can't keep my hands off it for long. So I pick up my ukulele and sing a mucky song. Here we go, I pop, pop, pop my ukulele and serenade the folk so gaily, singing something vulgar to my chums, chums, chums. I pluck for me dinner and pluck for me supper. I'm such a happy little plucker, singing songs about nudist camps and honeymoon couples and bums. So if you've got a gumboil or a pain in your bum, or your wife's run off with the dustbin man, now don't you feel glum? Don't hang around like a misery guts with a face that's 3 feet long. Grab yourself a ukulele and sing a mucky song. Here we go. And put, put, put your ukulele and serenade the folks so gaily, singing something vulgar to your chums, chums, chums. If you sit there and play by yourself, you'll either go blind or ruin your health, but you'll be the happiest plucker that strums. Singing songs about nudist camps and honeymoon couples and bums. Thank you, thank you. Do I get a series?
Having got the positive artwork, we then place it into the coffee sack over the stencil and then seal the bag, and then you're ready to turn the vacuum on. And then you're ready to expose the stencil for 3 minutes. Off, and your stencil's ready to wash out now. You just keep washing until the stencil starts to come through, which takes about a minute and a half or so. The parts of the stencil which the ultraviolet light touched go hard, and the pieces under the artwork that the ultraviolet light didn't touch will remain softer, so that you can wash them out like this.
The Islington Bus Company is a community information and resource centre. We provide facilities and equipment free to all Islington groups. Any materials that they use, as in the printing processes, they pay for at cost price. One of the basic tenets of the bus company is that we don't do anything for anybody. We train people how to do things for themselves. So in all the areas we work in print and sound and video, we have video as well, we run training workshops, sometimes on our own, sometimes in conjunction with adult education institutes. We expect or hope that people will come to us and make demands of the resources, and we hope to respond appropriately and to give advice and support.
Now, this is the poster that we just saw on the film. It's really beautiful. Was that a very complicated method?
Well, it's quite complex. There's quite a few printings in here. There's 8 altogether, and some of the stencils are photographic. It's a long job.
So now, but there are very simple forms of stenciling, aren't there?
Yeah, and that's what we're going to do today. It's paper stencils, which are the crudest form and probably the easiest way of doing it.
Right, well, we've got our design here. We're going to need 2 stencils, 1 for each colour. I've cut one out here already, and you can see that that one fits over where the window is.
Yeah.
The dots, I'll explain that later on. And then we've got another one here for the green.
Now, I understand that when people usually cut letters out, they cut them out completely incorrectly.
Well, and what happens is that if you just cut that little space in between the A out, all you'd end up with is a block letter without that little bit in, because it would drop out.
So you have to draw them.
You have to join them on to the main part
yes,
of the
stencil. Show us the snow blobs.
Oh, yeah. All these are bits of tape cut out.
Yeah.
And just sort of stored on there.
And they'll be transferred onto the screen.
Yeah, we'll just put them on.
Well, we're going to carry on with the stencil, and you can go and watch a film from Telford. See you later.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Telford Entertainers.
We're all entertainers as such, but not paid artists or anything like that.
Thank you very much.
You brought love like I've never known.
There aren't any stars at all. No, we're all equal and we have a job to do, and without anyone we couldn't put on the show. You know, nobody is any different than anybody else.
You're my friend when I'm hungry.
We try and involve them. We try and take them out for the evening. It might be fantasy, but it's fact to us that if we've pleased most of the people, then we're pleased ourselves. And that's our aim, to please the older folks.
Organised a number of shows for senior citizens, and out of this came the birth of the Telford Entertainers. We came together as a group who are from all parts of the Telford and indeed Shrewsbury area, and since the formation of the group we've been doing about 190 shows in just over 5 years.
Oh, that was absolutely wonderful. Thank you.
We also have, on very special occasions, had one or two professional acts, there again, coming free of charge to entertain old people at larger gatherings, because sometimes it's meant that we've entertained as little as 20 to 25 people. At another engagement, we could well entertain 500 people.
But we never want. Let's see.
Well, it's mainly for the old age pensioners, because a lot of people, particularly in the homes, they don't get the opportunity to see live entertainment. It also obviously gives people who've got the ability to entertain the opportunity to get out and have an audience.
Mr. Elvis Preston.
I hope other groups in the area and particularly throughout the country would try and do this for senior citizens, because the work is greatly rewarding to us, and I feel sure that the vast majority of old people thoroughly enjoy what we're trying to do.
If there were more groups around like the Telford Entertainers, wouldn't it be wonderful? Now, we promised you a juggler, Tim Batt.
These are devil sticks. They're endowed with the mystical powers of the Orient. They don't really look like it. And they are used to control this object here. Now, I don't toss juggle it as I do with balls. I get fed up with tossing balls around. So I'll just show you how this one works. There we are. It's rather pretty, isn't it? Lovely. And I'll do a few little variations there. You can do it on the one hand, and then, of course, you can do it on the other as well. Now, for those of you that think it might be connected some sort of string, that's for you. Some people do think there's magnets, there's wires, trapdoors, scantily clad assistants involved in manipulating this devil stick. Well, that's not in fact true, Jenny. You can have that. So I'm going to just attempt to manipulate this tennis racket in a similar way, just so as you know that there's no real trickery involved. It's really, you're playing around with gravity. You're feeling the weight of the object, and you can do all different things with it. You see, once you've got it going, there's a nice helicopter move. There we are. Now, you ready for this one, Jenny?
Yeah, of course.
This is going to be rather painful. There we are. Well done. She's done that. Right, now, let's see. I've got my Christmas dinner along here. Now, you see, I've got this chicken. Now, it's a little bit tough. So, you know when they bash steak around to tenderise it? They bash it. So I'm going to try and tenderise my Christmas dinner for you. Now, in the same manner with these devil sticks. There we are. It's a little bit more tricky. There we are. It's getting a little bit softer. Hang on, let's give it a little bit of a whirl on that one. Ah! Come on, back you go. Come on. There we are. It's, you get the general idea. Yeah. And you catch that one? Well done. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Screen printing is actually a lot easier. Now, what's the next bit?
Right, well, the screen has been stretched now, and
yep.
The first stencil's been put on, and you've put your T-shirt over a large piece of cardboard to keep it nice and flat for when you print.
Just to clear something up, these are the bits of snow.
Yeah, and they're just bits of tape. Cut out and stick back on the screen.
So that makes it quite clear that you've actually got to...
Yeah.
That's it, and that's going to block the ink. So
yes,
ready
that's
to print.
Right, OK. Over the T-shirt.
The T-shirt, get it straight. Make sure that you've masked out all the other holes around the screen, so the only clear bit to the screen is where the ink's going to go.
Oh, wonderful. And this is a squeegee, isn't it?
That's right. That's what you spread the ink with.
Wonderful. There you go.
Okay.
All right. Need somebody to help you to hold it.
Is there anything critical about how you hold this squeegee?
About 45 degrees.
Yeah.
Move it quickly. Press quite hard.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. And then bring it back again.
That's it.
Okay.
Lift it off and...
There
we go.
There we are.
Wunderbar. Isn't that wonderful? Well, look, we're going to set up the second colour, but you're going down to the East End to Chat's Palace to have a good time. We're having a good time too, but we'll see you later.
Don't forget, folks, the Bluebeard and the Barbary Coast Christmas show is the fourth Christmas show that we've done here, and the best yet, I think, yes, the best yet. Cast of 900 and Chats Palace, it's used to be the old Hampton Library, and it came out of the Hackney Marsh Fun Fest, which is the best local festival in Hackney. And 1975 noticed this building was empty, and the committee that ran the festival, local people, applied for the use of the building, and along with local groups set up what is now a very well-established project. The idea was to promote the festival activities, so it's performance, theatre, dance, music programme, combined with arts activities that link in with local events like the festival and like this project we've got on now, which is our biggest project of the year. As soon as last year's Christmas show finished, everybody was buzzing with ideas, what should we do next year? So we had some theme evenings downstairs where we showed films and talked about ideas. And we came up with the idea for this show. Just loose ideas, it's going to be a pirate number.
Look at the state of these men. It's disgusting. You there, smarten yourself up. Look lively. What do you not think this was, a pleasure cruise?
So
in about mid-summer, we were ready to start devising. And so a group of people devised that, ready for the Dave, who did the writing of the script, to go off and come up with a script by the time we came back from holidays in September.
Here, what? I had a letter from home the other day.
Did you?
Dear any, old England.
Any news?
Yeah, it seems they've got a new Prime Minister.
Yeah, who is it?
It's a woman by the name of Maggie Thatcher.
So in October we're all charged up, ready for the programme. So the programme activities in this show combines the arts activities for the props and design and the costume with the music from the Chats Orchestra, which is like our regular music event of the week and of the year. It goes on. And we're a 15-piece big band now of all sorts of, you know, great sounds coming out of that lot. And all the performance that happens in the year, it all comes together, fuses together for this big event. And so the workshops, the 2 months of workshops leading up to the 1 month of performance is equally as important. You know, it's just one big event.
Don't forget, folks, Chats Palace Christmas show, Bluebeard and the Barbary Ghost starts December 15th for 5 weeks. Here, give us a bite of that, Sam.
We're off to chase old Bluebeard across the Spanish Main. But Sammy and the crew feared we won't get back again.
Ahoy there, shipmates!
Ahoy there!
Demis calls him the...
The Barbary Ghost.
Tonight at 9 o'clock.
Right,
been
there, boy. All right. I've only got one pair of bands, tonight.
I would show you the mast, but I've just been informed it's a mizzen.
Let's pretend we're pirates sailing round the island. Let's pretend we're Long John. Throw your wooden leg on.
Here, what's up with you?
Slides were made by professional adults at the BBC. The next offering has been made by amateur children from Salisbury. Are you sitting comfortably? Then we'll begin.
We have liftoff. Come in, Mission Control.
We are loud and clear.
Emergency. We have lost contact.
Try the manual override. Nothing happening. Look out!
That was excellent. I want to know how you made the film, what equipment you used to make the film.
Well, we had a camera placed above a few scenes, and we had a few cutouts, people with joints, that sort of thing.
What sort of camera was it? Just an ordinary camera?
Yes, it's this kind of, it's rather that kind of shape, and it's got and all you've got to do is press this button, and it takes a picture.
And then what do you do once you've taken the pictures?
We move the animation, the figures, slightly a bit. Then we take two more clicks.
And then when you've taken all your clicks and you've had your film printed, then what do you do?
We put it on the steam back and we run it through, and then we chop it up and edit it on a special machine. And if there are bits in it that we don't want in there, we just chop them out and throw them in the bin. And when we're editing, PJ's made this special bin and you put the things in,
yes. I must stop you there because we're rushing here through the programme. But I think you've made the perfect choice with the bits that you've kept and the bits you've thrown out. And I know that you're making another film. Jolly good luck with that and have a good Christmas. Thanks for coming. We're now going to see what Bus Company's doing.
Right, the first print we made has dried. Yep. And this is the second stencil for the lettering. Just place it down like that. Get your ink.
Oh, lovely green stuff. I could get a job on Blue Peter Day. Right. Do it right. Here
no, go. Same as before. One right. Continuous pull and then back again.
Yeah.
And that should be ready.
Eureka. Oh, splendida.
There we are. It's printed. Wonderful. So you leave that to dry, and when that's done, you turn it inside out and iron it. So you've got to do that before you wash it, otherwise it'll come out.
Oh, I see.
But we've done one for you.
That's lovely. Thank you. It's very good. See? Hold it up to the light, not a stain in sight. Hold it up to the nose, and we've got information sheets on screen printing written by the Islington Bus Company. So don't take fright. Write. We asked Ivor Biggun to do us a Christmas song. Now, he wanted Dame Nenny Melba to give him a hand, and I said, I'm just as good as she is, so I'm going to give him a hand instead. Ivor?
Thank you very much. I'll eat it afterwards.
Yes. So here it is. Grapevine's Christmas present to you from Ivor Biggun and the D-Cups. Have a jolly good Christmas. Ivor, take it away, please.
Jolly good. Right, here we go.
Now if you're a frog fed up with your pond, or a rat that's sick of the sprint.
Now if you want to sell, or if you want to tell, or see yourself in print.
Or if you're a voice crying in the wildebeest, or if you're out of work, don't hide your watch, sit under a bushel, be like Captain Kirk, and get yourself an enterprise. And boldly go on through, get yourself organized, cause there's nothing you can't do. And if you're seeking inspiration that can't be beat, you'll find it in this lady's sheet.
What?
I said the chance will be a fine
Ivor.
Thing.
I said the chance will be a fine thing. Now, brothers and sisters, don't bust your crust. Help is at hand for the struggle of
love. Do you want to breed free-range wombats? Have you ever thought of learning how to juggle?
Do you want to make a movie? Do you want to write a magazine? What do you want to say? Do you want to print rude words on T-shirts?
Then be like Marvin Gaye.
She'll send you the gen, but it's not too technical. She won't tell you where she got those big red spectacles, but oh, she's so beautiful behind them.
Woo, woo! Ivor, this is wonderful. I'm having a great time. Okay, this is the age of self-help. The age of the little man, the small enterprise, the cooperative venture. I mean, what do you call a man who goes for what he wants, gets gets what he wants and gets it whatever the struggle.
A burglar.
Jeffrey Howe.
My boyfriend.
Wow, skanking friend, yeah!
Now what about Noah when the ark sets sail?
Self-help! Enterprise!
Oh, what about Jonah in the belly of the whale?
Self-help! Enterprise!
So what makes the oak from the acorn grow?
It's self-help! Enterprise!
And what helps Jenny get through this show? Valium.
And a lust for glory.
Anybody can do anything. She'll send you full directions.
Everything is better if you do it on your own, with one or two exceptions.
Self-help. I'm talking about the enterprise. Give me little enterprise. Turn the water into wine. Give me little enterprise. Heard it through the grapevine.
B, C, D.
Heard it through the grapevine.
A,
heard it through the grapevine.
T, L. We have free information sheets on how to make your own record and screen printing. If you'd like them, please send a large stamped addressed envelope to Grapevine, BBC TV, London W12 8QT. If you haven't finished your Christmas shopping, they make marvellous gifts.